Mike Siegel back at, we're on the set of our next movie, Jolt and I. Right now, right before we go to our next segment, the interview with Kane of Kane's Comics, I'd like to introduce the director of our next movie, Bill Siegel, in his directorial debut. Come on over here, Bill. How you doing?
Good, Mike. How are you?
Okay, and I've heard this is going to be a movie of mammoth proportions.
Bigger than Jurassic Park, bigger than Batman Returns, and bigger than Terminator 2, all wrapped in one. It's of incredible proportion. The amount of money and time and manpower being put into it is something that hasn't been seen in this industry in a long, long time.
Can you tell us something about the set?
It's very complicated. That building you see behind us here, that was constructed by a 100-man work team working 14 hours a day for 8 weeks in the desert sleet and storm. You know, we actually built the mountain behind it. You know, after you see that, it cuts off. We built the building, put in all the landscaping. It looks like it's been there for years, doesn't it? It's wonderful.
It's a school, though, right?
Yeah, it is a school. We're going for that John Hughes kind of style here, you know. It should be interesting.
An action, but with that twist.
Twist.
No. Twist. Anyway, thanks a lot, Bill.
No problem.
Hope to hear from you soon. And considering I'll probably be in the movie, I guess I will hear from you soon. Now, to our next segment, which is the interview with Kane. No first name, just Kane of Kane's Comics.
Hello, kind viewers, and we have another exclusive interview, but this time with Kane of Kane's Comic Shop. How do you do?
Hello.
We just have some basic questions to ask you, Kane. How did you get into the business of comic shops?
Well, no, it's been a hobby of mine, and I collected books for years and years, and finally my garage filled up. My wife said, get the stuff out of here, and I have a store.
Comics have always been kind of considered a children's thing. Is that still true today, or are most of your customers older or more of adolescent?
They've done a study and they found out that most of the people who collect comics seem to be male, between the ages of 16 and 25, and people who have a job. So hopefully the people are somewhat literate.
Well, that would be a good idea. There has been a big hype lately about Superman's death, even though, I mean, this was on the TV and everything. Is he still going to stay dead, or will he come back?
Everyone kind of believes that he's not dead. I mean, he's died 7 times before. This isn't a new thing. It's just they had more press than before. This coming week, there's going to be 4 guys who all claim to be Superman. A kid with shaved head and an earring, that's one of my particular favorites. Some kind of robot outfit, a cyborg. You know. Why have a storyline when you can have all these great-looking characters? Yeah.
Well, as a comic fan, what comic books do you enjoy?
I like anything that has a really good story and good artwork. There's some companies out there that are putting out some good things, but I also like the classic stuff like Batman's always been a favorite of mine. Sandman, who's a particular new character for more mature readers, if you want to call comic book readers mature. There's gimmicky things I kind of avoid, but we seem to sell a lot of them. In fact, our biggest seller here seems to be Ren and Stimpy.
Oh, really? Ren and Stimpy of TV show fame?
Oh, yes. A lovely cat and a rat. Or is it a chihuahua? Same thing.
Yeah, basically. So, besides Ren and Stimpy, what are your hot sellers this year?
Well, it seems to be Superman Return is obviously going to be a big seller. We've had hundreds of orders for it already. This Batman, they're going to be damaging the character, so people seem to be buying a lot of him. DC seems to like to destroy the characters to build up sales. Anything that has popular artists that people seem to be fond of, like Todd McFarlane, Jim Lee, people who who, if you're in the industry, you know what we're talking about. People who, you've never heard of these people, you would know what I'm talking about. The biggest seller seems to be aliens, vigilantes, psychotics, and mutants. You put all those together, you have a hot-selling book.
Besides comics, do you also sell other items?
Yeah, we do sell cards, but only if they're related to comic books or fantasy or that type of thing. Original one we opened, we got into the sports cards, but sports cards has just gotten too bizarre, and I got out of that really quick. We seem to sell merchandise that relates to comic books, toys, posters, yeah, the usual, what they call pop culture.
What new things are happening at Kane's Comics?
Let's see, well, we're moving at the end of the month. That's a big event here. Any type of move generally is. A lot of people seem to be involved in wanting to help us. We've had several offers for people who want to do paint the walls and do all the dirty stuff, which seems to be fine with me. We also have a lot of people coming off the street who are really interested in Superman coming back or Batman getting his back broken or whatever, so they reserve books with us, and we're happy to do that for people. In order to stay in business, you have to have some type of gimmick, and we got ours. Ours is that we keep a little card here, and when people buy things, we keep track of it, and when they spend $100 worth of stuff, we give them $15 in free things.
All right, thank you very much for letting us interview you, Kane. It was a very pleasurable experience. And if somebody wants to visit Kane's Comic Shop, where do they go?
Right now, they can come to 749 West Dundee Road, which is on Dundee near Elmhurst. And after the end of the month, we'll be at Dundee Road in Schoenbeck, right by Hepcat Records.
Oh, really? Sounds good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Once again, we're back.
And we have some terrible news. The director of our next feature, whom Mike interviewed in the last introductory segment, was pronounced dead this morning of a gunshot wound to the gut, a projectile wound to the gut. It is not known for sure if it was a gunshot wound. It was a
all play is suspected.
It was a terrible on-the-set accident. He was carrying a box of Dunkin' Donuts for the crew, and he was shot right through the bag of the box of Dunkin' Donuts. And he is now dead yet, but there's going to be an autopsy, and we will find out of what causes. But while we wait, here's our next segment. It's a psychedelic film, so just enjoy, okay? It was a beautiful day outside. The birds were chirping, the sun was shining, and I was enjoying an ice-cold Coca-Cola outside on my deck while relaxing.
Garage where I retire. An accident. Let's go check it out. Holy cow. What happened here? Looks like some guy had a little problem with his parking job.
Yeah.
Look at the rust build up on this baby. Oh, and there's a dead guy, too. Seems that somebody ran this son of a gun over and took off. Son of a gun only goes up to 85 miles an hour. This has to be a clue. I've got that sixth sense. I say we get out of here. Ha! A Reese's peanut butter cup. Easter. I'm taking this as a clue. I've got that sixth sense. You know, that really ruffles my britches when people do stuff like this just for the sake of fun. A piece of wood. No, he could have beat somebody over the head with this. And there's the other half. Wait a second. Now, if you follow the diagonal of the splitting hairs, you get a hypothesis of the parabola divided by the dimensional analysis of that circumference. Little shards of glass. There's something here, folks. I just don't know what. You know, that really ruffles my toes. Will you shut up? Son of a banshee. These Dixie boys running up and down on their 1970s bicycles, picking flowers. The heck? I'll be god darn if this is gonna be a hard mission to accomplish. I got a funny feeling about this place. Like there's something around here I don't know. Let's investigate. There's a bush, and there's a man!
The evidence had paid off. I found the suspect exactly 15 feet away from the scene of the crime. After all, I'm the best, aren't I? I decided force was needed, so I looked around and saw a hockey stick.
Song. Traveling along, there's a song.